Bylaws. Importance of creating and maintaining effective bylaws. Your bylaws serve as the governing document for your booster club, so it is important to make sure it covers all the basic activities for your organization. First and foremost, it should outline the purpose and basic goals of your booster club, define the executive office positions and describe their basic duties, responsibilities, and term limits, list standing committees and describe the tasks they are charged with, establish the fiscal policies of the organization, outline when regularly scheduled and emergency meetings of the Executive Board and General Assembly are to take place, and most importantly, define the conditions under which the bylaws can be amended. Periodic review and amendments. One of your standing committees should be a bylaws committee charged with the task of periodically reviewing the entire contents of the bylaws and producing a list of recommended changes. Those recommendations should be provided to the Executive Board for further review and input, then presented to the General Assembly for approval. Changes can be accepted as is, with modifications, or in part, with other parts voted down or floored for further discussion. There should also be a procedure defined for any member of the General Assembly to recommend amendments to the bylaws. Your bylaws should also state the basis for parliamentary procedure, usually assigning Robert's Rules of Order as the default set of rules to follow. However, it should be noted that the club's bylaws supersede any other rule, guideline, or operating procedure. Therefore, it is also important that the bylaws do not conflict with any IRS, University Interscholastic League, UAL, Northside Independent School District, Northside Booster Association, or school campus policies. There should also be a reference to the version or most recent date of amendment printed at the end of the document or in the footer area. As far as the layout of your bylaws, there are sample bylaws available, but a good practice for creating new bylaws or tailoring your existing bylaws to a more effective format is to use a similar club's bylaws as a guide. Most clubs make their bylaws accessible on their website in various file formats. It is not recommended to copy their bylaws word for word, but reviewing them may allow you to adapt a particular format or remind you to include key points that are not currently covered in our bylaws. The PBUSA and Boosterland websites also provide sample bylaws that you can use as a guide. Accessibility of bylaws. The bylaws are also considered a public document, so it should be made easily accessible to the public. The best way to do this is to post it on your website. A paper copy should also be kept along with your organization's binder and should be made available to any state or federal government agency or financial institution that requests it.